Hello, today I have the possibility to ask our product expert some questions about the SWR, the spool welding robot, a cobot that is used in spool welding, spool and pipe welding, prefabrication of pipe weldings. Thomas, this system solution SWR is a major investment. For what users is that interesting and how is it about the return on invest?
Hello, Jan. Yeah, it is true. We have a nice situation to have this SWR as an instrument of modern automation. But unfortunately, we have in the world market of welders no possibility to have experienced welders enough. Mm-hmm. Our problem is then we have to exchange it. How we do it? We do it by the SWR. The SWR has the knowledge in the background. And also, we can calculate the cost of this big amount of an investment with an ROI lower than 2 years. Mm-hmm.
But for thinking about the invest, I mean, you have to have a certain amount of pipes that you weld.
Yeah, for sure. You need amount of pipe inch diameters per year that you can invest in such a solution. But on the other hand, you have also flexibility in this solution given by different positioners, given by modern measurement tools, given by storage of parameters, and also for the safety, you can control later by camera videos what you had done before.
Yeah, when the weld is done, you just unleash the brake, you take the SWR to the different positioner with a different diameter of spool, then you can weld there. In that time, the other positioner can be prepared for this for the next round.
Yeah, for sure. There's also maybe another man from the logistic can load and unload the spools
right
during the welder is working in one positioners, but we have the maximum possibility to integrate 5 positioners. Mm-hmm. So it is independent where the welder works. It is always something to do.
When you say 5 positioners, up to 5 positioners, how far can I move this WR around?
Oh, that's a good question. We have the possibility 9 meters diameter to use in a free designed positioning of these positioners. Yeah. The location of the positioner or the design where you put it, the positioner, is free and depending from your order, from your customer order. Mm-hmm. When you have a pipe length of 6 meters, for sure, you need only 1 or 2 positioners. When you have a lot of small spools, you can integrate, how I told about, 5 positioners.
Mm-hmm. In pipe fabrication or spool fabrication, there's still a lot of manual welding done. If I go the step for automation of these processes with the SWR, what is the main challenges? What are the things that I tackle there?
Yeah, you have to know that is each part is different in a pipe shop. Yeah, you have different dimensions, you have different lengths, you have different parts to combine. And so any situation, any part is different from the other. Mm. So what we can do, or what the experienced welder is doing, he has a lot of information. Sometimes he wrote it maybe in a notebook, yeah, and we need this information from the intelligence from the machine. This intelligence is stored here in 60 RPCs controlled by a PLC, and for sure we have also measurement tools. They are combined with the machine equipment, what we can choose all the time, and so it is much easier to integrate it in the manual process. The difference is I need also not really an experienced welder. I can learn or train from an experienced welder and use an operator in the active process to work with the SWR.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and with the SWR in times of pipe welding, I start with the root and I do all the different layers with that system. I'm not interfering with manual welding anymore.
For sure, it's possible. It's depending of the WPS. There are some descriptions to use it, but mostly for sure you are right. We can use this way, and we controlling beginning from the root pass by a laser seam tracking system, the positions and also the symmetry in the gap. And we have also some functionalities to take care during the process for tack positions and the root positions, maybe to minimize energy in the gap.
Mm-hmm. So an experienced welder would just understand the parameters that the SWR offers and then position the torch in the right direction to the spool, and at the end do some fine tuning, and then he could just start welding.
For sure, yeah. That one part of your question is the position of the hardware. Mm-hmm. And the other part is to have the knowledge about it. Mm-hmm. The knowledge is stored in the controller of the SWR, and it is all the time existing to use by the welder.
There's different ways of automation of welding processes. Here we're talking about pipe or spool welding. Can you describe a little bit in the detail what is that turnkey solution offering to somebody who has a lot of pipe welding?
The approach is here to have a human control for all processes during the welding and on the positioning also. And we want to minimize for sure the defects and also to have an increasing quality in our processes. We have to see that we can choose the parameter from the root to the cap here, and we have automatically switching between the processes. Mm-hmm. They are integrated maybe also in the power source, and they integrate it also in the positioning system. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we have automatical offsets where between from the root to the gap, the arc can spring in defined parameters. Mm-hmm. That is an automatically process where the welder has all the time influence, but it is also programmed in the machine. But it is not to compare to a robot solution, because there it is much more complicated to program it.
Mm-hmm. Can you describe a little bit the possibilities for the operator to interfere with the task that he has while the welding is going on?
When the welder or the operator reached the position, he is supported by different tools and he has also a lot of measurements during the weld. So the operator has a teach pendant, what he holds all the time in the hand, and so he can control all the time, but supported is this system by an arc camera, and we have two laser seam tracking systems for the geometry and also for the movement of the pipe generally. Mm-hmm. He using this pendant to have the control on one side, and on the other side he had to have influence to parameters, maybe for the positioning and speed, maybe for the symmetry in the geometry, maybe for the tech functionality, he can have a higher level of power. There he use a special program when he welds over the tech position. Also, he has also a root safe functionality to take care when there is a bigger gap that he not break through.
Oh, okay.
And these all are used and stored by a direct teach-in, so that he has not need to adapt more activities and to program like in a robot solution.
In pipe or spool fabrication, productivity is real key. How does the SWR as a system solution increase productivity in these shops?
I would say that is a turnkey solution, and with this turnkey solution we work in a range of 2 to 60 inches in standard, more as possible. But the increasing of the productivity and effectivity we can measure in some kinds. In first it is the positioning. Yeah, we can jump between positioners really fast. We have a cycle of 2 or 3 minutes to change parameters, to change the position from position to position, from positioner to positioner.
To different spools.
To different spools, to different tasks. Mm-hmm. And so we have a huge range to be really flexible in a working diameter of 9 meters. Mm-hmm. And we can integrate in this diameter positioners maximum 5 pieces.
There's different ways of automation. If I take an industrial robot, I need a robot programmer. This is a spool welding cobot. Do I need a programmer here as well?
No, Jan, you don't need here a programmer because this is a collaboration robot mm-hmm. with all advantages of this. But for a standard robot, you need a training, a special training to learn the language of the robot. Mm-hmm. Here we have stored experience in the PLC and the welder or the operator is choosing only the stored data file. Mm-hmm. And then he can directly influence by direct teach-in or by adapting the parameters and then he can use it. So it means at the end, he don't need any training from the supplier or from the company like BINZEL. He can learn by himself by an experienced welder.
Mm-hmm. So an experienced welder is able to teach the SWR the details of welding the customer specific pipes, let's say.
Yes, and also what we talked about in the beginning, the experienced welder is important to work for difficult parts, mm-hmm. for more difficult parts than a pipe spool what we use in a mass or in a fabrication flow, like here. So we can make a combination. The experienced welder can work on more difficult tasks and the organizer or the operator here can work by the support of the SWR as turnkey.
Okay, how about IoT, welding parameter documentation and recordings? What does the SWR offer in this terms? In these terms?
Yes, we have IoT here on board. Yeah, the system from the base is able to be connected with a network. Mm-hmm. So we are also in the situation that we can control it worldwide. Mm-hmm. And on the other side, there is an integrated welding data documentation where each weld is stored mm-hmm. in different forms we have it. We have a video.
Okay.
We have stored parameters in the Excel sheet. Mm-hmm. And also we can analyze it by a diagram. Mm-hmm. So we can have 3 different possibilities to look directly on the machine. Or we can also analyze in the computer, or we can do and use copy and paste in our computer.
Okay, Thomas, thanks for answering all the questions. I hope that everybody could get how this SWR as system solution turns key solution in pipe fabrication or spool welding can increase productivity. Thanks for your time. Further information on that SWR spool welding robot you find on our website. Thanks for watching. See you next time.